What's up, everybody? What's up, people? The picture you see is a good friend. I say she's a good friend because I'm not going to talk down to her or talk bad about her. But this is Ester Goldberg. We was friends since 07 on a site called Now Live. But today I posted a video on her profile on Facebook, and she blew it out of proportion. She got mad because I posted a video about Fat Boy Get Down, and she blew it out of proportion. She just blew it. I couldn't figure out why would Ester blow this out of proportion. And it was kind of fucked up that this woman blew something so small out of proportion. I'm not gonna talk bad about her, because what's the use of talking bad about somebody and making the situation much worse? Because, you know, if I did something wrong, people can come talk to me and we can work this out instead of fighting about it over the internet. Well, she didn't want to do that, and I thought it was okay. It's like, okay, why? I apologized to her, and I said, okay, I'm sorry that my video got stuck on your page. Like, I mean no harm. Like, I'm sorry about this. But instead of sitting up and saying, okay, I understand, she blew it out of proportion, and still she talked all this shit. And I'm going to show you what she said. I'm going to definitely show you what she said. Because I thought, okay, this is kind of fucked up. Oh, is that? See, she says, hate when people post crap on my page that won't delete. And here is where she said, Ester Goldberg. From Afrojoe, some lame ass video, YouTube video. Didn't say nothing bad about her. Then she got some other people talking smack about me. And like I said, I didn't say nothing bad about her. I didn't talk smack about her. I didn't go around, oh, fuck Ester and all this. Now, I didn't say nothing about her, but I know she's gonna take this out of concept and blow it out of proportion. She's gonna blow it out of proportion where she's gonna make me look like the bad guy. She's gonna make me look like the bad guy, like I did something that terrible in the world. She think I just robbed somebody. And I'm gonna show you what I posted up on her profile. Because it's kind of funny how she took it out of proportion. She says, Ester, that's fucked up. You said my shit is lame. You lame ass, and I never talk shit about you or talk down to you. I always supported you as a friend, even when a big titty bitch was talking shit to you. Yeah, back in 07, New Year's, around New Year's, Crystalina talked shit about her, said she was a man in drag. Never talked bad about Ester. All I mentioned, when the big titty girl was talking down to her, everybody had her back, even me. I said, how do you even know my shit is lame anyway, if you don't watch it? Before you pass judgment on somebody's shit, watch it first. I said I was sorry, but you blew it up like it's Pearl Harbor. Instead of you coming to me as an adult and talk to me, you had to act like a child and put it out there in the open. Now, you can call me all the names you want, but you know I am right. Like they say, it gets lonely at the time. I didn't call you no names. I didn't pass judgment on your video. But you can pass judgment on your friend's word. Where is the support? For your friends, Ester, I see you as a friend and not as anything else. Didn't talk down to her. Didn't say shit about them. Didn't sit there and say, fuck Ester. Didn't say that. Didn't say this. And I get treated like I'm somebody, some damn criminal. Now, how do you get to run around talking smack about me and I never sit there and say a damn thing about you? Then she writes something else on her status. When I posted that comment, she removed me from her friends list. And look what she said. Yeah, I know you have an impact on the world when you piss people off on a daily basis. Look, I heard, like, I'm gonna tell you this from Jump Street. I'm gonna tell you from Jump Street that I hardly ever talk shit about anybody. I hardly ever do. The reason why is because I didn't want to lose no more friends. I didn't want to lose the friends I still had. I already lost a lot over the last 4 years. But for her to post that shit about me instead of cut, cause she actually left a message, and I will show you the message. And I apologized to her. Said I was sorry. I didn't mean to do it. She didn't want to work it out, so she posted that damn status. Like, okay, that's messed up that you want to post a status talking all this BS on me, but you can't work it out. See, this is where people get fucked up on the spot, and they get all butthurt what's been said. Because she thinks it's awfully funny. She thinks it's funny. Because one thing, there's bigger things in the world besides this damn video. Just one video. It didn't say nothing about her. Didn't talk bad about her. Nothing. I'm still ain't. But she gonna blow this video out of proportion like she gonna do. She's gonna blow it out of proportion. Because I know how that is. All this, oh, after y'all talking shit about me, I'm gonna do a video on him and make him look like a dog. Look, there's people dying on the streets every day. Kids getting shot over nothing. Kids getting killed out in the street. People dying from AIDS and cancer and other diseases. People that was in the army, the troops, got killed overseas. Their kids are not going to see them no more. And you sit there and you have the audacity to blow this one small video out of fucking proportion. Now that's fucked up that you take the smallest, little bittiest damn thing and blow it out of proportion. Why couldn't you do a video about, several kids won't see their parents next year or this year on holidays or whatever? Nope, that wasn't too good for you. She don't want to. That wasn't too good for her. I would do one. I've actually said and talked about certain issues that happen in the real world, the real world, current events, as you say. Like the mother that killed her kids because the mother that killed her kid because she was playing Farmville and the baby was crying, or the woman that killed her newborn twins because she didn't want her parents to know she was pregnant. How about that? I talk about incidents that happen. I don't go on here and talking shit about every damn body. I don't talk about you. I don't talk bad about Agent Curry. I don't talk bad about Crystalina. I don't talk bad about Forbidden. I don't talk bad about Buddha, a.k.a. Jessica Badafuco. I don't talk bad about y'all because y'all like family. Why would I want to talk about my family? And it has come down to it that all this is about is over making yourself look good. How do you talk so bad about somebody that's trying to... And it just fucks me up. Like, I'm gonna show you what she sent to me, and I thought it kind of hurt. Like, I'm gonna show you what she said. Like, you posted some spam ass YouTube on my page that won't delete. I deleted you and tried to add you back. Please do not post this shot on my page. I said okay. It was just a video I did. I'm sorry. It won't delete and I can't remove it. Hope it will remove. Piss me off. The fuck off. Okay, I got my Facebook friend to remove it. I meant to say again, I'm sorry, Ester. I didn't mean to get the video stuck on your profile. I apologized several times saying that I was sorry. Y'all seen it. And she took it out of proportion and got mad because of over something so small, something so small, where there's the bigger things in life to complain and bitch about. Why is the smallest thing is a big issue? I'm gonna tell you this. I'm gonna tell you this story because a friend showed me this story. But like last year, it was around April when my friend told me, Ash. good friend of mine. She told me about the story about this girl. This girl, she's 20 years old. She was in college. She did YouTube videos. And the last YouTube video she posted was on a fucking Wednesday. And she died on a Monday. What happened was this 30-something-year-old man was bipolar schizophrenic. He didn't want to take drugs because he don't want to be a prisoner in his own mind. So he kept doing video response to this girl's videos, talking shit about. So Wednesday, when she posted that last video, they went to the same college, by the way. That last video she posted up on Wednesday, Monday came around. That 30-year-old man, his name was Tony. The 30-year-old man, Tony, walked in her classroom. She's 20 years old. And he shot this girl right in her chest, then shot himself. He blew something so small, out of fucking proportion, because what she posted up on YouTube. Now, I'm gonna warn people, watch what you say and do on the internet. It's gonna get you in some big shit that you don't wanna get into. Why would you sit there and do shit like that? You're causing an issue. If you had a problem with me posting a video on your page, the best damn thing to do is come to me and talk to me instead of broadcasting it to everybody in the fucking world. Because to me, you're letting everybody in your personal business, in your personal life. You're letting people know what the fuck you had for breakfast, which porno movie you gonna jack off to. You're letting people know. Instead of you coming to me as a grown person and working it out, you had to sit there and go, Afrojoe, he denied it. I know you're gonna say that. You're gonna blow this little problem out of proportion. All I wanna do is talk about it, work it out. I wanna talk about it, work it out, and maybe we can fix this incident between us, because I still wanna be your friend. I don't wanna fight. I don't wanna do none of that. I want to still be your friend. All I'm asking is, like, can we fix this issue? Can we be friends again? Can we work on this situation? That's all I wanted. I ain't call you no names. I ain't call you no fake ass. Nothing. All I'm asking, can we work on this? Can we fix this problem? That's all I'm asking. And I know you're going to blow this out of proportion. I know you're going to go back and tell your Facebook friend, fuck Afrojoe, da 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 da. For what reason? To make yourself look good? How many times? Like, you really want people to just... You just want people to laugh at me over something silly. Is that what it is? You want jokes. I know you're a comedian. That's what comedians do. But how far does a joke go? How far does a joke go? That's all I'm asking. That's all I'm asking. How far does a joke go when you lose everything? Like I said in that comment, it gets lonely at the top. And that's how it is. Because I think it's unnecessary for to blow this out of proportion. That's all it is. Because I'd rather work on it than sit here and fight about it. See what I'm saying? I want to work on this, not fight about it. If you don't want to work on it, you don't want to fix this issue, fine. Then everybody knows that you're acting like a child. If you sit there and do a video talking all this shit about me, you'd rather be a child than a grown-up. You'd rather sit there and run away from your problem instead of fixing that problem. And for your friends to step there and say, oh, he's stupid, you is just as guilty as she is. If Ester go, I ain't talking bad about Ester. If a person goes out and shoots somebody and you see it all, you is just as guilty as the person pulling the fucking trigger. But all I'm saying, Ester, is can we work on this? Can we work this out and become friends again? I'm not talking down to you. I'm not talking bad about you. I'm not calling you no name. All I want to do is work this out. How many people can you, how many people ever came up to you and say, hey, Ester, let's work this problem out? Because I want to work it out. I don't want to lose a good friend because over something so small. If it was something big, something fucked up big I did, yeah, I can understand. When it's something so small, let's work this shit out, because you got kids killing themselves out in the street. You got kids killing themselves in the house. You got kids getting bullied in school, cyberbullying. You got people dying every day on the street. And you blow this itty bitty problem into a big problem. You never turn a small problem to a big problem, because it leads nowhere. You take a big problem and you make it small, then you work it out and get it done. I'm not putting you on blast like that. I'm not saying, oh, Ester's this and this, because I'm not that fucking evil. I'm not that damn evil. People might say, oh, Afrojoe's very evil. He talks so much shit about me. That's hearsay. That's hear fucking say. That's hearsay. When you believe in hearsay, you believe in people's lies. If they say the great, if they say, like, not okay, check this out. Y2K, when people said we all gonna die in the year 2000, people fed into it. And look what happened. They bought things that they didn't need, and they wasted all that money. That was hearsay. Same with the, oh, we all gonna die in 2012. That's hearsay. Hear fucking say. Ester, I'm not dogging you out. I want to fix this little issue and move and become friends again and move on from this, because I never talk bad about you. I never caused a problem with you. I still remember times that me, Bad Dog, C-Ro, Miro, Tina Roe, Jason Wild, Adrian Curry used to be off in your fucking room laughing our asses off because you made us laugh. We had fun chilling in your room. I know that was the past and this is now. I want to put this issue behind us and look towards the future. Because I hate losing friends because of something so small. Don't take this as me talking down to you. I'm just saying, let's work it out. Can we just do that without sitting up there continuing to fight in videos or Facebook or MySpace or Twitter, something like that? I don't want to fight like this because you think it's cool to do. I want to work out a situation that is great, that's right, that's the right thing to do, because, you know, fixing the issue is best thing to do. Because I know one thing is, you probably going to do another video talking very bad about me. Oh, Afrojoe, that's acting childish. That's acting childish. Nobody can look up to somebody if they're going to act childish. I can't see you as an adult if you do a video, oh, Afrojoe's this and this, or post on your Twitter, oh, Afrojoe's a motherfucking fool, or put it on your Facebook, oh, Afro's a motherfucker. You're acting childish. If you're older than me, I don't think acting 14 should be the best, because one thing is, I'm 27, you're older than me. Why is the oldest person acting my age and I'm acting your age? How come that happens? How come I'm acting your age and you're acting my age? That doesn't make no damn sense. It really doesn't make no sense that a 27 is acting Ester's age and Ester's acting my age. I'm not saying that's a good thing. I'm damn sure they're saying it's a bad thing, but I'm not dogging you out, Ester. I'm just putting this out front, telling the truth. All I want to do is keep it real with you and still be friends with you so we can talk it out, because I don't want nobody else. Because one thing is, if you get a lot of people into it, it causes a bigger issue. Because they might say something about you, oh, well, you're done. See, it might be a bigger issue if you let people get on this issue. It's not about your fans or your friends. It's about me and you working this little issue out and becoming friends again. It's not about all your friends and all your fans. It's about working an issue out and trying to keep it real. teach the world, even though the smallest little issue can be fixed. And that's all it is. If you like, this has been Afrojoe. If you don't like what the hell I got to say, you can kiss my ass. If you do like what I got to say, leave a comment, leave a video response. Like I said, if you don't like what I say, don't leave a comment, nothing. Just move the fuck on. If you, and plus, leave a video response. Follow me on Twitter. Holler at me.